Code generation is one of the most important features of gRPC. In this lecture, we're gonna learn how it's done with protocol buffer. In order to generate steps for the server and client, we first need to write the API contract, which includes a description of the services and their payload messages in a protocol buffer file that looks something like this. In this file, a hello method is defined, which takes a hello request as input and returns a hello response. The hello request contains only a string name, and the hello response has a string grid. Very simple, right? We will learn much more detail about this later in the hands-on with protocol buffer lecture. From this proto file, the server and client stub codes are generated by the protocol buffer compiler or proto-C. Depending on the programming language, we will have to tell the compiler to use the correct gRPC plugin for it. The generated code for Rust and Go will look something like this. Okay, so you may wonder why gRPC uses protocol buffer. Well, there are many reasons. First, it's super easy to read and understand. Second, it's language interoperable with automatic code generation for many languages. It represents data in binary format, which is smaller size, faster to transport, and more efficient to serialize in some text-based format like JSON or XML. It provides a strong type API contract between client and server, which is super safe to work with. And it has a great set of rules for API evolution to ensure backward and forward compatibility. Sounds pretty amazing, right? But is protocol buffer required to work with gRPC? The answer is no. You can use Google Flat Buffers or Microsoft Bond instead. But in my opinion, protocol buffer is already a great choice. It supports a lot of programming languages, with 10 officially supported, where Go, Java, and Node.js are purely implemented, and 7 others are wrappers of the gRPC core C, namely C++, C#, Objective-C, Python, Ruby, Dart, and PHP. Besides, there are many other unofficial libraries for other languages, such as Swift, Rust, TypeScript, Haskell, and so on. Alright, now we know how gRPC generates codes for us. I hope you find it interesting. In the next lecture, we will explore another secret weapon of gRPC, which is HTTP version 2. See you then.